All right, so now we're going to jump into Mega Man 6, the final of the six Mega Man games in the anthology on NES for the Mega Man series. We'll watch the intro here as I tell you a little bit about the game. The game didn't come out in the States until early 1994, which is extremely late. If you know your Nintendo timeline for consoles, you'll know that SNES was out by the time Mega Man 6 came to NES for like 3 years. So this is a very late game. It's a game that a lot of people played. And Capcom had its concerns about this particular game selling in the West, and so they opted not to publish it here. Instead, Nintendo published it. They localized it and published it themselves, which is unusual for Mega Man, but it's the case. It was still published by Capcom in Japan, though. The game has a pretty predictable storyline. It's a very, very similar to 4 and 5, where Wily is the bad guy, but he is disguised, in this case, as Mr. X. But in the others, you know, he was blaming Dr. Cossack and Proto Man. So it's a very similar story, similar formula, 8 enemies, and then you go into 2 castles. But the impressive thing about this game is we go to Flame Man and start there. Is that it's incredible this game runs on the NES at all. It's a very intensive game. The backgrounds are beautiful, the music is fantastic, the sprites are lively and well made. It's really cool to kind of see the way Mega Man had changed over time. And that's what's so cool about this Mega Man Legacy Collection that I'm playing these particular Let's Plays off of, is that you get to kind of track the genetic makeup of the Mega Man games. So we're cruising through here. These oil fields, by the way, if you let those flaming enemies drop their flames on them, they will alight. And then you will have to deal with flaming oil underneath your feet, which will kill you instantly if you touch it. So we can just avoid that enemy, actually just keep climbing up the ladder. These enemies need to be killed with super shots only, or the shots will bounce off of them. They also turn into these pads when you step on them, which will get you over the oil. Of course, the oil doesn't hurt you if it's not a flame, but it's going to be a flame. As you can see here. And if you touch that, it's basically like touching the spikes. It'll just kill you automatically. So we're cruising along here through the oil fields. Fantastic music, by the way. Some of my favorite music in all Mega Man is this stage. So these flaming enemies that will shoot flames out of their heads will also cause you some problems with these oil fields, as well as these enemies that will rush at you when you're on their platform, similar to enemies on all of the Mega Man games. So let's do away with these guys. There's an E-Tank down there. Let's grab it from the safety of this flameless oil. Too slow there, so he lit that one up. And this one's gonna get lit up by these guys too. We might as well not even bother with them. And we're already to Flame Man's lair once I can make this jump. There is a weapon, yeah. You can, but I don't have any weapons yet. In Mega Man 4, for instance, that weapon that can destroy those enemies, like the blade enemies in that, would be the ring. And boomerang. So he has basically 2 attacks. You're only seeing one of them right now. There's the other one. And he's a bit of an annoying character to deal with. I'll just use an E-Tank here to be safe. This game's E-Tanks are quite plentiful. Not fighting them too well here. But we're getting through. And it looks like I won't even have to use that E-Tank, so that was a bit of a waste. But we'll have plenty of E-Tanks to use later on. We'll find more. And we really won't need them on any of the other bosses. The Robot Masters, anyway. So with that, we get Flame Man's weapon. And we can move on to the next stage. Will be Blizzard Man's stage. Some pretty cool art here that introduces the Flame Blast, which is his weapon. And we also get the Rush Power Adapter. Now, one of the cool things about Mega Man 6 compared to the other Mega Man games is the way Rush interacts with Mega Man in Mega Man 6. It's unique. It's a little bit time-consuming and a little weird. It changes the way the puzzles work. I'll show you. I won't talk about it. I'll just show you when it's time. And you'll see exactly what I mean. So we'll go to Blizzard Man next, who's basically just a skier, which is awesome. Really cool design. And I'll get into it a little later, but as you may or may not know, I don't know if I explained this in the other Let's Plays, or you might just know this, but all the Robot Masters in all of the Mega Man games, with the exception of one, were created by fans of the series. And Inafune would then just draw them in the proper style to make them all kind of congruent with each other. All of the games had design contests run by Capcom in Japan, so all the enemies, the bosses from 2, 3, 4, and 5 were all Japanese. 6 was the only example in the series up to this point where the enemies, some of the bosses were designed by Westerners. Specifically, Nightman and Windman in this game were designed by an American and a Canadian, which is pretty cool, and you'll see that in the ending when we get there. So you can see those shield enemies return. So here we're gonna use the Flame Blast just to get through these barriers, which is pretty cool. We get that E-Tank to add to our repertoire. And as you can see, in case it's not evident, I am sliding around here. Man, that was bad timing. Well, it's bad timing too. Man, oh man, I'm getting beat the fuck up here badly. Gotta recalibrate. So here, I'll take the time to show you what I was talking about. Well, you go to the power adapter, and you can see here, I'm not gonna let this animation play every time, but Rush combines with Mega Man and gives him powers. So the power module here, if I just hold it, will destroy these blocks with cracks in them, and that's basically the use of them in this game. Now, if I can quickly get out of this and slide under them, there we go, right to the ladder, that was slick, but I shouldn't be bragging too much since I just got hit like 8,000 times there. In a pretty bad array here. I'm a little Mega Man fatigued, I gotta be honest with you, because I've played these games so many times. I've had the Legacy Collection for a couple weeks before it even came out, and then I've done all these Let's Plays, so, you know, I really just wanted to show these games off to you. If I want, maybe in the future I'll start recording what I think are, like, some really solid, like, this is how you really play. But it takes time to get those kind of Let's Plays. So we can destroy these if we want, just get them out of the way. We don't have to do that. So here, because things go up and down, I can actually manipulate that. Like, his bullets will go up here, and then my bullets will actually go down here, and I can try to hit him with them. Try it with... I'm a little too close, I think. There we go. And this thing's going up and down. The spikes will kill you, of course. So we'll go back to the power adapter. We'll destroy that, and then we'll let it reset. And then we can actually sneak in here and get some stuff, including some health, and then another E-Tank. And we'll let it go back down. So you can see already how the stages are just way more intense in this game than the others. I think it actually started really with Mega Man 5 when you saw stages like Starman stage and Gravity Man stage, but it definitely hit the crescendo here. And these things obviously are timers that will explode if you stand up for too long. So here you can just kind of go over them, use them as platforms. This guy will get in front of him and try to kill as quickly as possible. And then we're already to the end. So here you can use these bombs kind of in a strategic way. And I'll show you what I mean. If you go that way, and then you jump down here, and then you jump on this, and then you go like that. And then there you go. You're through. So Blizzard Man's pretty simple even without the Flame Blast, but he'll be mincemeat with it. And he has basically two attacks. He has an attack that creates like a blizzard on the screen and shoots some snow at you, and then he curls into a snowball as well. And when he does that attack, he can't be attacked at all. So you gotta just kind of get out of his way. He cornered me there a little bit. And that's the end of him. So Blizzard Man's done, and we get the Blizzard Attack, I think is what it's called. All right, so with that, we go to Plant Man. Now, Plant Man is by far the silliest designed robot. I don't understand what they were really thinking with this enemy, but his stage is really cool nonetheless. It's actually pretty hard. And I actually quite enjoy the stage, just playing on it. The enemies are kind of unique. There's some really difficult obstacles to deal with later on in the stage. So So we can use the power on that if we wanted to, the power type, but we're not going to. We'll just continue on. So these guys, you kind of just want to avoid. Although they are like damage spawns, but not so much. But you can just avoid them. It's easier. So sometimes enemies behind you aren't even worth messing with because you can just get them to scroll off the screen if you really wanted to, but they can come back and haunt you, so it's smart to kill enemies as you go. Here's Eddie again. Introduced to Mega Man 4, also a feature in Mega Man 5. Here we'll fight a mini-boss that's based on Gutsman, I think. Kind of like Gutsman meeting a... Oof. So you hit him in the arm to kind of push him back, and then you hit him in the eye to... do away with them. That was pretty bad showing on my part, but we're surviving and going through. Oh god. These guys are gonna be annoying. So get rid of them. A little bit of slowdown. Gotta be careful with scrolling these enemies off screen here. You gotta be careful not to jump. If you press jump, you'll just launch right into those, which is no bueno. And then we'll fight another one of these guts dozer type enemies. And he's done that was way better than the first performance. So here's where things get a little hairy. You gotta like kind of balance how you're jumping, you gotta balance all these enemies that are flying all over the place like a bunch of idiots. These platforms can be used if you shoot at them to kind of avoid obstacles. Ugh. These of course are health, if you wanna use them. One more pop out, but you don't want to get overzealous with the jumping. Here you want to be kind of careful. Draw the fish out. You can get to the corner a little bit more just to make sure you're going to make the jump. And then go. Jump over that guy. Keep on going. Another fish is going to pop out here. He's got a high jump. So just keep going. This gun is on the bouncy things here, which is ridiculous. I don't know how they even got there. And then we... Ugh. Let's see if we can kind of hop over here. Avoid that. And then we go. And then we're at Plantman's lair. Now, Plantman continues the proud tradition of... Mega Man robot masters that use shield or barrier weapons. So think Woodman, think Skullman, think Starman, and now think Plantman. They all use pretty similar identical weapons. Plantman's a bit of a pushover though. And he's weak, not surprisingly, to... I think his weakness actually makes a lot of sense. Because he's a plant and, you know, you're using frost on him. So this is a good place to start if you don't want to start with Flame Man. The reason I start with Flame Man is just to kind of get... I just like that stage. But a lot of people start there, it's not terribly uncommon. And then we should be able to do him away with this one. And then Plant Man is finished. Stupid Plant Man. And we'll use his weapon. Getting text messages here. Check on those real quick. So we'll get the plant barrier from him. And then we'll use it on, as you can see here, it's not a very impressive weapon. But we'll go to Tomahawk Man and use it on him, and I love Tomahawk Man, I think it's a really, really cool design. We'll go to the restricted area. And here's the first example of a stage. So Mega Man 6 is interesting in the sense that, there are multiple ways to beat certain stages, and to beat certain stages properly will net you certain items. Specifically, our friend Beat, the bird. But there's more than that, because now that we have the jet adapter as well, which I'll show you in a minute, which is the other rush adapter in addition to power, we have some more options here on how to beat stages. And this is unique pretty much to Mega Man 6. So destroy that enemy. I love that enemy. Really cool. Yeah, we can continue forward here. I have a charge buster to deal with these guys as they appear, so they don't cause you any problems. And then we cruise up this ladder. And there's Eddie again. What does he got for us? Knee tank, sweet. Well done, Eddie. All right, so here's our first choice. I love that background, by the way. That background's amazing. We can go right, but we won't. We'll use the jet adapter and fly up with it. And the jet, as you can see, changes the whole notion of Rush Jet, really, in the game. He can fly, but for a very finite amount of time. So you kind of just got to take a leap of faith here and then land on the platform. And then wait for it to be at the top. And we'll grab that. And then here we can find an E-Tank, and we'll leave those other, we really don't need those. And then we can just drop straight down back to where we're supposed to be. And then we'll switch back to normal Mega Man. Deal with that enemy. Again, you're going to want to kind of just avoid these guys as best you can. And then we'll fight with this guy. We're not quite in the strategic place we were with the other one, so we got to be a little more patient here. We can just get over here, though, and deal with him in a more direct way if we wanted to. Oop, jumped right into that. And here, all right, so here is another choice we have. And because we have both Blizzard Attack and the Jet, we can deal with this in a very succinct way. So we can use the Blizzard on him to get rid of him. And then we can jump right into this hole with the Jet. Take this alternate route up to an alternate layer where we can deal with this son of a bitch named Tomahawk Man. Oh! Why didn't it let me in there? So you could be a little more patient than that, I guess. We'll take the normal route this time, since I'll learn my lesson. I'll show you what that's like. But we'll still take that other route. Here it's pretty direct. I mean, there's just nothing going on. Those are the skulls you like, though, isn't it? You like those skull enemies from 4, which make a return here. That was an untimely death, but we'll get back to where we need to be. So deal with him. Again, we can kind of just slip right through here. We'll do that. We'll continue on to the right. And then we'll just do exactly what we did last time. We'll just use the Blizzard Attack again. No harm, no foul. And then we'll use... Oh, by the way, I didn't show you the jet animation, so I'll show it to you once. Which is pretty cool. Oop. So then we go here, draw him out. Kill him before he even turns, which is nice. Get through here. Go down. Ah. Not an extra life, which we don't really need, but we'll grab it. I'm talking shit, I mean, I just died, so maybe I will need that extra life, who knows. How many do I have? I only have 3, actually, so. Who knows what situation we'll find ourselves in. I'm going to avoid that energy this time, as that was blunderous. And then we'll equip the plant barrier to deal with Tomahawk Man. Here he is. So I'm out of energy because I use it too much, so I'll have to switch over. I might have to use... He shoots his feathers at you, which is kind of cool. Whew, that was close. So So he's done there. I use the, so you should have enough. It reminds me, what's a good example? Like when you use Gravity Man's attack, Gravity Hold on Gyro Man in Mega Man 5, you have just enough to beat him. And if you spam it too quickly, he'll still be invincible from his last hit, and therefore you won't be able to use it. So that's basically what happened to me there, in case you're curious. It happens. So we got beat B parts because we beat basically the real Tomahawk Man as opposed to the fake Tomahawk Man. You would not know the difference in the fight. But when you go back to the stage select screen, you'll see here that the B appears over him there. And basically these are the enemies that, so Yamato Man, Night Man, and Centaur Man, we're gonna go to Yamato Man next, where you'll find all the beat pieces. So Yamato Man is basically like designed after, you know, like ancient Japanese kind of samurai. And this stage is interesting because I have no idea how it deals at all with his subject matter. But here we can sneak right through here, and I gotta show you. So there's like an alternate path here. If we use the power attack, we can just go right through. We'll leave that just in case we die and we need it later. Here we'll deal with this interesting mini boss. A lot of slowdown here. And then our reward basically for taking this route is an E-Tank, which we can grab with the power adapter again. And this is the only frustrating thing really about Mega Man 6 is that like you can't shut off like that scene happening. You can start through it, but it still is not quick or fluid, which is quite unfortunate when you're switching to the power adapters. So up there is where we would have come from otherwise. And then we all kind of congregate here in the same place. And here is another choice. This time we can use the Rush Jet. And this is another reason why I take this specific order through as well, is just to make sure we have the appropriate, not so much the rush stuff, but some of the appropriate weapons. For instance, actually, I still need the rush in here. Having flames to use on Blizzard Man stage is pretty nice to be able to get that E-Tank. So that's the end of him. Continue on. So here, another choice. And we'll use the Rush Jet. And here we are at the end of the stage already, and we switch over to Silver Tomahawk, which is Tomahawk Man's weapon. And it's a hard weapon to use, as you're gonna see, because it arcs up. I'll use one here so you can see it. It arcs upward. So you have to be able to use it in a way. You have to really kind of stay on top of your enemy, or you're gonna miss. Yamato Man's funny because he shoots the spear, but then he has to go and run and get it, which I think is kind of funny, as you can see here. And there he is. Done. And now we're gonna get the Yamato spear. And we're gonna go to my favorite enemy now next in this game, which is Nightman. Really, really awesome design, as you will see. And we have the E parts for beat now as well. So Yamato Spear is very simple. It reminds me a lot of the Needle Cannon in Mega Man 3, although when you shoot it, it goes a little bit up or a little bit down. So next up, Nightman. Great design. Ball and chain attached to him. And a shield, which is cool, which blocks actually attacks. So it's actually a practical thing. Cool stage as well. Reminds me a little bit of King Knight stage in Shovel Knight. So those enemies basically have to be prodded out of their hiding place in order to kill them. This part's a little hairy. You gotta kind of just be careful. Find a place to hide from these spikes. Kind of just get through, just take your damage and just get out of there. kind of introducing some spinny platforms for you that you first saw actually in Mega Man 5. So they're reusing some of those assets. Can't really blame them. So here, kind of bring him out and hit him, and then he exposes himself and you kill him. Oh, ran right into that one. That was okay. Ooh, Eddie's being quite generous today with the E-Tanks. Quite generous. God, I feel like we already have like six. Seven. We have seven, and I used one, so we would add eight. So these enemies have glasses on, and you shoot them once, and then they freak the fuck out. And there's another E-Tank up there, which we can get with the rush jet. So these bombs you'll remember from Mega Man 5 as well. Just kind of bail them out, or draw them out, kill them before they even run into you. These bouncy platforms you gotta be careful on, or they'll run you right into enemies. So you kind of just gotta go like that. And kind of use them. Oof, geez, not showing this very well. All right, so here's another option. So we're gonna go down here, use the power adapter. And you can see that there's a boss there, but we don't want to use that one. We want to use the one down here. And Kevin was asking before how you kill these guys. You kill them with a loaded thing like that, if you want to. So here, you just destroy that to make the jump. And then you switch over to your Yamato Spear. Yamato Spear is a weapon that Nightman cannot block. You can expose him with anything. In fact, starting with Nightman isn't necessarily a bad idea, actually, if you wanted to. But again, starting with Flame Man just brings you along this particular journey. Is my stick down? Oh, I was like, why am I running to the right? My analog stick was pressed down again. So that will give us Nightman's weapon. We can move on. We're almost through. We're going to fight Centaur Man next, which is maybe one of the more unique enemies. So Nightcrush, and we got the A parts as well for beats. We're almost there. It's basically just a projectile, a big ball and chain projectile. Nothing too fancy. So now we'll move on to Centaur Man, very mysterious creature. And he's guarding the ancient city. And he uses a weapon in the time-stopping variety. So think Flash Man, think Bright Man, etc. So there's an underwater portion here. What would a Mega Man game be without one of these? Remember that you're going to be extra buoyant and have a little bounce because you're underwater, which is good. You can use it to your advantage. It can also be used to your disadvantage as these spikes lining the ceiling are attempting to prove to you. So just make your jump carefully. Kind of reminiscent of Bubble Man stage a little bit. If you're feeling unsure, you could just use an attack, like let an enemy hit you to make you invincible, and then it kind of makes things a little easier because you can touch the spikes for a brief second, which you might find useful. Let's see if we can get to that before it disappears. Nope. So here, this is an interesting little puzzle. The water's like upside down. You can use it to jump high or low. And so can your enemies, like this guy. So wait for it to be where it needs to be, and then leap. Get rid of those guys, come in here, grab that since we need it. And then we climb back up the ladder. Eddie appears again. We can't keep getting E-Tanks, it's not fair, so he didn't give us one. It's rare to get one E-Tank nonetheless too, we've already gotten two on this plate from Eddie. So these guys are basically submarines, you just want to kind of get out of here. Not even mess with them. Let these guys congregate. And then just kind of avoid them as best you can and get out of there before they cause you trouble. Here you're going to want to draw some more enemies out if you can before you continue along. So here's another option. We can go down the ladder, or we can use the rush jet to make this leap to the real Centaur Man. And before we jump in, we're going to want to equip the Night Crush. So Centaur Man's tall, and he's actually hard to jump over. He can also disappear and reappear. Can stop time, as you can see there, and then use this thing to hit you. That's the end of him. So Centaur Man's done. We're going to get his Centaur Flash here, which we'll use on the final enemy, Windman. And Windman's kind of derivative. I mean, Nightman's super unique. Windman, I mean, there's it's very similar to Airman. So this is a very similar weapon to ones I've kind of made fun of in the past, where they don't really do anything. They are like a full screen attack. So again, think like Gravity Hold in Mega Man 5, where you just hit it and it just happens. So here we are on Windman's stage. Robotic pandas, why not? So here you use these things to kind of rise up. Can be difficult to time it. Oh, messed that one up, but it doesn't matter because we can grab this. Kind of sneak our way out. Here you gotta be really careful not to jump into the air. You kinda just wanna walk into it, or otherwise you'll go into the spikes. That's why they're there. These platforms can be tricky. You wanna jump on them like this and they'll change ways here. Now, so there's actually a way for us to get something up there if we want. So I'll go back and use this one again. And we can go up here and grab some energy as well as an E-tank. And I don't know how many E-tanks we even have. We have 8, so we can actually get one more. So this will be useful for us. And then up we go. You can slide under this guy. If you want to get that extra life, you can. No need to really do that. So here you can actually hide. You like can't hit you there. Here things can get a little crazy. Here you just need to be very careful. Oh, that was dumb. So here you need to kind of move over to the right quickly, quicker than I did it. We'll take the more straightforward route here this time. Sorry about that. Don't want to waste your time. The thing about Mega Man 2 is a lot of people, the games are hard. The games are definitely very hard. But they're not insurmountable. You learn how to play Mega Man, and you just know how to play all of them. And so even if you have a snag, like I just did, I've died twice now, I think, on this playthrough, that's okay. Just get back in there. Don't get frustrated. Mega Man thrives off of your frustration. I'm not talking about Mega Man himself. I'm talking about the games. Mega Man doesn't like when you're frustrated. Oop. Still having a little bit of problems with the PS4 controller, just learning how to play these games on it. It's just not quite as smooth as I want it to be. It's not really a reflection on the series, it's or on this Legacy Collection at all. It's actually really a reflection on just how what I'm used to playing is. Or with, I should say. Alright, so here, you kind of just have to move over quick. Oh my god, I can't wait to die again! Oh, Kevin, I'm struggling here.
I'm sorry, can I get you something? Water, another
god, beer? Give me an air conditioner, it's hot as balls in here. No, I just gotta stick with it. It's no big deal. How many lives do I have? I have 5 lives, I'm fine. Ay, ay, ay. On the last stage before we get to Mr. X. It happens. You die, you cruise on. Take my own medicine. I just said that you gotta keep cruising and that's what you gotta do. I feel like my play is getting worse the further I get into the series, but it's kinda just the way it goes.
But you did a lot in a row.
I did.
And this room is unbearably hot.
It is. It's really hot in here today. And I don't know why. We weren't really in here that long, were we? We only did it one. Like...
Is it warm outside?
Could be. I did like my burrito. Thank you for asking. It was very good. They do a good job over there. You know, I've kind of come around on them a little bit.
Me too. Once they reintroduced the refried,
they had it. There we go. Also, they had refried and then they didn't for a while?
No, I misspoke. They didn't have it. They introduced it.
Oh, I see. So, Centaur Flash is what we'll use here, and you'll see that it's just kind of like whatever. Windman is just I don't know, he's kind of a boring enemy. So here, you just use it, and it just works. And then you wait until he stops flashing, and then you just keep using it. You don't have to aim it. Oh, I wasted one there, so. We'll finish him off with the Mega Buster. That's it. Windman's done. So now all... Sorry, that was a little more difficult than it should have been. All 8 Robot Masters are now finished. Which allows us to move on. To Mr. X. Who's... I feel like I'm getting a lot of text messages specifically during these Let's Plays. Okay. So it's just a little tornado. Nothing too fancy. It's like a carried away. So then we go to Mr. X. I feel like an exorbitant amount of money is spent on these palaces, these castles. So I love this background too, because again, it shows the city, it shows like real life in this world, which I think is kind of cool. So here you kind of got to just use the rush jet a little bit, and you could use, so there's another thing you could do here, actually, I'll show you guys, since this is one of the ways Silver Tomahawk is like quite useful. You can just do that, and it arcs right up to him, but you can save that if you want, because you are going to use the Silver Tomahawk. And remember, your weapon energy does not replenish in Wily and X's castle, so you got to keep an eye on that. So there, if you want to get really crazy, you can get in there. There's really no reason to. We don't need anything in there. Let's deal with these. Get rid of one of them, and then... Oh, went right into that one. Okay. Oh. Missed it. So you're gonna have to deal with these enemies again. At least I didn't die. I thought I was actually gonna eat shit there, Kevin. I do wish I was a little less out of practice with the late ones, because I just don't go back and play them that much. I'm like so up Mega Man 2 and 3's ass, obviously, that like any self-respecting person, I'm just gonna get rid of this guy because he's annoying. Oh fuck! Oh my god! There we go. I'll probably still die. Let's see. There we go. Okay. Continue on. These guns just won't go away. I don't know. That's a good question. Alright, then make the leap. So those guys drop bombs on you. You can deal with them if you want. How you want.
The skulls have a different, like they have feet this
time. Oh, they're set a little different. Yeah, they might have adopted or adapted the sprite. No, so this is an E-Tank I don't think we can carry, so I guess we're gonna have to start using them. Or it's just a waste. Because you can only carry 9. Yes, others let you, I think 4, 5, 6 all let you carry. Actually, 3, 4, 5, 6 all let you carry 9. Technically, with 5's M-Tank, Mystery Tank, yeah, so you can come up from that route too. That's the other like alternate route you can take. I guess there's technically 10 in that in Mega Man 5. So here, some people like to use the arm cannon. I don't mind using the flames here. You just gotta kinda aim them carefully, flame blast. You're hitting them in the side. So that's the end of that boss. Then we move on. This Firestone, I'm telling you, this Easy Jag IPA, very tasty. Very tasty. Light. Surprisingly light. Yeah.
Firestone knows what they're doing. Mm.
So here, this is basically teaching you that you can go into the floor when those things appear, and we can actually start replenishing some of our shit if we need to. And this is gonna draw those enemies down here as well. Let them destroy themselves and then. So here, the jumps get a little crazy. You kinda just gotta lightly jump. Here the platforms disappear, so you kind of just gotta, if you want to be fancy with it, you can go here and kind of catch your breath. And then here you're gonna have to use the rush jet. Cross. And so this is basically saying, like, you can go down there, but there's nothing down there, and for the future ones, you're gonna want to stay away from them again. He can't get up there.
He's trying so hard.
But he is gonna come this way, so I gotta deal with him. Ugh. They are very persistent. Oh, actually, I don't really need it for anything. I guess I can use it for... I will be using the Silver Tomahawk very shortly, so I might as well Make sure I have all of it. And we'll re-equip it. This enemy was so clearly made for this weapon, you'll see. It's kind of funny, actually. So you just spam him. I'm not even gonna bother like trying to avoid his attacks. Just get him while the going's good. And that's the end. So we continue our cruise through X's castle. This is Mr. X, not Mega Man X. I like X 1, 2, and 3 very much. Very much.
Are those lines accurate at all?
They are, yeah. In a way, yeah. Actually, we don't need to go up here. It's just a waste of time, because I think we're all maxed out on E-tanks and whatnot. Let the enemies pass, and then you're gonna want to use Rush Jet here just to kind of be safe. The idea here is that going on one platform will affect the other, where the other is. So again, the jumping gets a little crazier here. Get it to a place where you want it. Kind of let these guys pass by if you want. And then... yeah. And then you kind of want to sneak into this way. That way. And then switch back. This jump's a little precarious, so you just want to be very careful. You can take either route. I'm just going to go up this way again because there's really no reason to go the other way. We don't need anything right now. Plus, it's just basically a quick escape route for you. So again, you want to be careful. Have Rush Jet as a fallback. And you're actually going to need it to reach some of these. So here, we're gonna be in a bit of a bind. Oop, my stick is stuck again, there we go. Jeez. So here we can use power. To kinda go through here and grab some health. We'll switch back to the jet. We'll just sneak in here, and for this enemy, we'll use Blizzard Attack. I love that the floor is moving to give you indication that like he's coming at you and you're moving, which is cool. And I love that it's just being piloted by like a met. Oh, I'm out of energy. That's what it's not.
He also doesn't
look
like
no.
Yeah, I love that. It's like
he knows he's gonna lose. So our showdown with X is Mr. X. is right around the corner. So here we should spend some time to replenish. Well, we're out of blizzard attacks, so we should get some of that. While the going's good. Remember, these platforms will turn over very Castlevania 3 style, so keep moving. And here again, the jumps are a little crazy, so just be careful. Tank right now, so we'll just keep cruising up. Just ignore that. These enemies are a little annoying, so you kind of just want to stay on top of them. They're basically like eggs that hatch into birds, but not like Mega Man 2 style. Like, it's just one bird and they dart at you, so you crack the egg with one hit and then you have to deal with the repercussions of that. They'll hatch themselves if you don't hatch them, by the way. So. Here, we'll just use Blizzard Attack to kind of get rid of these guys. So here's the birds you're talking about here. Gotta go. And if we want to get fancy with it to replenish our health, so here we have some options. We can go, well, not really. I mean, we would have come down from a ladder from another perspective, basically. So, as you can see, Mega Man 6 is rife with alternate options for you to kind of traverse if you'd like, which is cool. I think really cool, actually. And these jumps are pretty tough, but not insurmountable. Tank down there, we're not gonna get grab. Oh god. Here, well, I'm gonna jump over this. Say. Keep moving. And then. Concentrate there for a minute. And so here we're going to use, oh, I thought the game was crashing for a minute. We're going to use Flame Blast to deal with this particular foe, who is X, Mr. X. And you need to hit him in the side. Exposed for the crook he is. Failed spelled wrong, which I like. I was always disappointed in that like you don't really get the proper introduction to him that I desire. from here. We're gonna have to just time it to get this Met up here as he exposes himself using the jet. Something like that. I took way too much damage there, but. We can just avoid him. We don't really need to fight him. So there's a really tough jump coming up here, by the way. That like, I really hate a lot. It's not that, it's coming up. You'll know it. There's two of them in a row. They're really, really quite hard to deal with. We just want to get there because I'll probably die at some point and a lot of slowdown here. So here you want to get enough air, because then that wind will push you down and into that spike. So you just got to get enough air there. All right, so here's where things get a little crazy. So you got to. There, like that. And there's one more that's even harder. This one. There we go. Got through. That's really, really tough stuff. Probably the hardest part of the game. If you play for yourself, you'll see. We could use some of this. And so we shall. Are already where we need to be. And for this enemy, we'll use the Yamato Spear. It's a weird enemy, but it's like a dinosaur kind of. These platforms that strategically come out of his stomach for some reason to damage him. No, just his attacks. And that's the end of him. He's done. Fuck him, Kevin. That's right, that's his spirit. Our E-Tank situation is still strong, so I don't even need to bother with this. Yes, there is ice here, just like Blizzard Man stage, so I will be sliding around. Oh, that was badly timed. Just made that one. So here, we're not even gonna, trifle with any of this shit. We're gonna just use the Flame Blast to get through this. I hate the Spearing Block puzzles. So we get rid of that with the Flame Blast, and then we just go up here. What'd you say? I did. I do. Thank you. Is there a smell? No. Sorry to hear that. I don't know if you knew this about me, Kevin, but I smell perfect all the time. Mm-hmm. It's unbelievable, isn't it?
You can make an argument right now.
You could make an argument. That's what you really insisted on wanting to do. Good answer. All right, so we're here, and on this enemy, we're going to use Windstorm, which is the only time really you're going to see this attack. pretty much. We might use it on Flame Man as well later. I love those bubble attacks will actually take the wind out, which is cool. So he's done. And we're cruising right along here. So things get a little hectic here with these fans. That will pull and push you towards spikes. So now is where we want to really start replenishing what we're actually going to need. And we're going to need basically everything for fighting the robots again. So here, Blizzard filled up. Okay, we're out of the water, out of the danger of those fans anyway. Get these guns. And now we're in familiar territory here, which is the portal room for all the robots that we will fight again. So we'll deal with the Yamato Man first. Remember, tomahawks are useful on him. Struggle than I'd want it to be, but he's done. We'll deal next with Plant Man. Use the Blizzard attack on him.
I don't think he's that silly looking.
You don't think so? It's a flower.
Yeah, well, you know.
I'll show you like the actual art of him and you can make a decision for yourself after that. How's that? So I'm gonna run out here. What'd you say?
Is there any way that you can find the original drawings that were submitted?
No, I don't think those are available. I'm sure Capcom has them. That is too bad. I'd love to see that. They have released some things that weren't used, but I don't know if they've released. I don't think they've released the ones that have been. I could be wrong. The end of Nightman. Here we deal with Centaur Man. Windman. Chump-ass Windman. Here we deal with Tomahawk Man. And then we go up, and we deal this time with Flame Man. And we have a weapon that will make quicker work of him now with the Windstorm, which is convenient. It will actually cut right through his attacks, too, which is cool.
When you were younger, how long did the first playthrough take you?
Like, sometimes a day, sometimes a weekend. I remember getting Mega Man in 6 pretty vividly, because I was at that point I was like 10 or 11. And then finally, Blizzard Man. And for this, we'll use Flame Blast. That is the end of him. And then we go on here. So here we can quickly grab what we need. So we're going to be using Silver Tomahawk, and so we should grab that and then get out of dodge here best we can. Get this mini boss real quick. And the reason this enemy exists here, I do believe, is to let you farm, I want to say, so if you need to. We have 90 tanks, so I think we're gonna be just fine. And there's Eddie, one last time. From ZF Force. An extra life, not really what I needed, but it's fine. Oh god. What do you take? And then here. And then one more. And this, for this one, we're gonna use Silver Tomahawks. And we'll just use a new tank just to be sure we don't shit the bed at this very last moment. And we didn't really need to use it at all. That's the game. Mega Man 6 is complete. Wily begs for mercy as usual. Let's enjoy the ending together. I won't talk during it. I'll wrap my stuff up now. I hope you enjoyed all 6 of those Let's Plays, this being the final one that I've recorded and that maybe you were watching. Let me know what you think. I hope... just encourage you to go out and try these games for yourself if you haven't, or relive them again if you enjoyed them when you were a child, like I did. So that's Mega Man 6. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time on Kinda Funny Games. Mm-hmm.